Hello. Wanted to make this quick video to show some pictures of the Jeep that I am selling. I am still working on the price. And okay, I don't want to make this long, so I'm going to shut up and I'll only speak if there's something that I want to point out in some of these pictures. Now, this is going to be a rough slideshow. Didn't really have time to organize it, so I just pulled a bunch of pictures from my phone. And okay, enough with that. Here we go. And these wires, the red and black wires, I have a spotlight in the back of the Jeep. I also have a CB connected and a dash cam. So these wires are not an original part of the Jeep, and these can be taken out. I forget which company made this bumper, but this bumper will remain on the Jeep free of charge, along with the shackles free of charge. And of course, the original bumper will come with the Jeep. There is some slight rust starting to form around these bolts, but it's not major. Close up of the shackles. And this wire is just to secure the cotter pin, keep it from coming out so the shackle doesn't come off and get lost somewhere. But there's nothing going on, nothing wrong with that right there. Yes, the engine is a little bit dirty, but it's not affecting anything. And I did want to point out, okay, it's not in this picture. Okay, maybe in one of the other pictures. Okay, I think this is the picture I'm looking for. Come on, work with me. Okay, it doesn't show very well, but if you watched the previous videos, this does have a lifter tick issue. I took it to the shop, got it diagnosed, had the, the header, valve cover, I can't remember, but one of these covers was pulled off, and the mechanic looked into the valves and the rockers and the arms and all of that to see exactly what was going on. And I think this might be one of those, some of that sealant they use when they replace the cover. I know it's gray. I can't tell with this picture, not the best picture. But in case I don't see it in another picture, there is some sealant, or I guess it's called a valve cover gasket sealant. I don't know, but that's on the engine, and that's what it's for. That's what it's from, rather. Okay, and is this picture sideways? I think it is. Okay, yes, this is taken from, I believe this is from the passenger side of the engine. Disoriented, but yeah, that's it. Okay, this is some of the underbody of the Jeep. And one thing I want to point out, Jeeps, and I've done some research online, so this is not a problem unique to my Jeep. When shifting, sometimes there is a clunk. I'm not a mechanic. If you're a mechanic, or if you're a Jeeper or hardcore Jeeper, you know more about this than I do. So I just want to make any potential buyer aware of that fact. Their clunk is there from some time. All right, I don't know what's causing it. And from the forums I looked at, different folks had different opinions and thoughts and ideas about what was causing the clunk, so I won't speculate. Okay, more of the underbody. This Jeep has been through some rough terrain, but I did no rock climbing or nothing extreme like that. Just went through some water and mud and, regular stuff, but nothing really crazy. No modifications to the underbody except for a 2.5 inch lift. If you have questions about any of these pictures, feel free to ask. That's one of the reasons I am putting these up on my channel, so any potential buyer can look at them and see what it looks like, and if they have questions, they can ask. I'd hate for anyone to be interested in the Jeep and then come to here to my house, look at the Jeep, and then they see something that they were not aware of when they saw my videos or some pictures of the Jeep. I've gone through that before and it's not a good feeling, so I don't want to put anybody else through that. Okay, this is, I believe that's the oil filter. It's a little grimy down here. I want to wash this off, but I just haven't gotten around to it. I will get around to it, get it cleaned up. Not trying to hide anything. Okay, and by the way, here's that liquid sealant. I guess it's considered liquid that the auto shop put on there when they replaced that cover, whatever this cover is right here. That's it right there, and that's why it's there. All right, again, I have some accessories connected to the Jeep, and these can be taken out at the request of anybody who's interested in buying it. This bar was put here to secure the CB, and these are some of the CB wires up here. So this is not permanent. All right, a view of the front seats. And here's the manual and the door removal kit right here. These are aftermarket. This will remain. And I do have some leaks, some water leaks coming in through this door, mostly this door, sometimes the passenger side door, and sometimes this driver's side back door. I don't think any comes in over here. I can't remember. Now, right here, it's not really visible, and I'm going to point this stuff out in case I forget to mention some of this stuff, because I will be making another video about the same thing I'm talking about here. I'll be going over it again, but there are some cup holders that I added on because we all know that these little nets on the door, they sag after a while. So the nets are still there. I believe. Yeah, I'm sure I left the nets there. Yes, it's here. I believe I left the nets on both doors. Yeah, I didn't want to remove them, but I did add the cup holders right there. Any parts that I added to the Jeep, if anybody who's seriously interested in buying this, if you don't want those parts there, I will remove it except for the front bumper and, of course, the lift. Right, so yeah, these grab handles will remain, and I will be removing this weather stripping I'll put right here to prevent water coming in. They worked for a while, but after a while, they did not work. Let's see. Okay, the manual. Don't know what's causing this right here. If you are have experience with this, you know more than I do. Don't know why that's there. All right, this here was caused by my bracket I used to secure my high lift jack. There is some scuffing and scratching on this bar and the other bar. This here, this might have a small tear, but this is not torn. This part is not torn. This is Velcro. The Velcro attaches to that side over there, so it's not torn. And this white, the inside right here, this part, this has some dirt on it that I just need to get around to cleaning that up. Okay, it's more visible here. There's some little spots and stains in some areas. All right, this is the hardware for the original suspension and the screws, nuts, bolts, and the everything that was removed by the repair, the insulation shop that's in this box. All original parts are included. Anything that I removed or had replaced that's in there. Okay, now these are the little center caps or whatever they call. These will be, okay, these came with the rims that are presently on the Jeep. Right now, if you look at the picture of the Jeep, you'll see the little center caps have the Jeep logo on it. Those belong to the original rims. And so these will be with the, those will rebuild. Ooh, okay, blubber, take two. Those center caps will be replaced with these, all right? Okay, and all the equipment, the jack is here, the grab handles. I don't think, I'm not sure this is an original part, but it will be included. Again, these are some wires for the spotlight I had hooked up. The antenna, there's a CB antenna, and this is just a package from that antenna. Again, that can be removed. All right, the mileage. Let's just call it 96,000. This engine light stays on, and that was because of the lifter tick issue I mentioned earlier. So that stays on, and I'll talk more about the lifter tick issue when I make the video. All right, nothing to see here. And that is the Jeep. This rain cover can be included at an additional cost. And I believe I have a picture that shows what it looks like when it's on the Jeep. By the way, this sealant, I put it on the seams just to prevent any rain from getting through. Never had a problem with it leaking, but I guess I'm just overcautious sometimes. So I put it on there. All right, this is what it looks like. And I think I have a side view. All right, here we go. Now, keep in mind, this cover is meant to be put on the Jeep when the doors, okay, not necessarily the doors, but when the hard top is removed. So when right now the hard top is on, as you can see, but I didn't want to take the hard top off just to put the cover on. So, but if you're interested in seeing what it looks like, you can go to the Rain Gear website. It was on one of the pictures. You can see it and go to the website, check it out. But just imagine, if you will, that the hard top is off. And of course, it's going to come back slant down right here. And that's just how this top fits. It'll slant down and it will fit right above this fender right here, right along there. And then of course the straps are to strap it down. And I want to point this out in case I forget about it. Now I did, when I removed my doors, of course I have to have mirrors because these mirrors go with the door. So I did have some mirrors, but I cannot locate them. If I locate those mirrors, they will be included with the Jeep. This is, I believe this is called I believe this is called a bikini top. I'm not sure. But if you're familiar with Jeep, you know that this is put over the top of the Jeep when the hard top is removed. And it only covers the top from the windshield to that back roll bar. It goes, that covers all that area. And this can be obtained for a small price. Didn't realize I had this many pictures. All right, a couple of scrapes and scratches. I did use this Jeep, all right. So it does have some blemishes. It's not perfect. All right, nothing else to see here. All right, the back seat. All right, I had this added. After I bought it, I had this added, the hitch added on. All right, folks, and that's it. And as I said, I will be uploading a video talking about everything, including the price of this Jeep, in the next few days. So if you're interested in this, stay tuned. There's more information coming. I don't like being one of those people who's selling something and they don't tell you the price. Or if they tell you the price, you have to call in or email them to get the price, or they have this hour-long video and they wait to the very last minute to tell you the price. I don't want to be one of them people, but right now I'm trying to do some research online and come up with a fair price for this Jeep, considering that it does have a issue with the lifters. So just hang in there if you're interested. The price is forthcoming. All right, thanks for watching. Bye.